schedule which has already been upheld by five judges of the Supreme Court. I wonder why they went for an amendment knowing full well that the law was already upheld by the Supreme Court.
I want to ask you two questions before I let you go. One is that something which the Congress Party has raised, and repeatedly they keep telling us in the press conferences, the choice of the lawyers of Sachin Pai. Is that a fair thing to say? I mean, you know, people can choose their lawyers.
No, I'm sure that Sachin is entitled to choose it, of course.
But why did he choose a lawyer who has supported the BJP on the case?
He's entitled to choose the decision. Any lawyer belonging to any party. For example, I am a congressman, right? And I belong to the Congress Party. Would I appear for the BJP? Unlikely.
So if he goes to a lawyer who has fought or defended the BJP,
No, I'm not saying fought or defended. It's not a question of fought or defended. Anyway, I don't want to comment on my colleagues.
And I have to ask you this question because you're the one who triggered it off as a senior Congress leader. You have commented on the Congress Party when you tweeted your first tweet about you cannot let your
boss. You were talking to me about the 10th schedule. You meant your questions to that.
Okay, you don't want to talk about the politics of it, but the civil.
You know, mine not wanting or wanting. You asked me what you want to talk about. I said the 10th schedule. You said fine. And now you are exceeding your briefs.
Okay, fine. I won't exceed my briefs. I will not be a lawyer. But thank you very much, Mr. Sibbal, for putting this into perspective, for giving us those legal nuances. Thank you very much for speaking to CNN News 18. So, Sneha, we heard what Mr. Kapil Sibbal had to say. And it's a very interesting point he also made. I mean, he as a congressman would never fight for anyone who is actually representing or is from the BJP. I think that was a very critical point that he also made.
Interesting developments there. Thank you, Pallavi, for that. That interview also, in fact, will be up on our website. But before that, there is some news which is just coming in, wherein Union Minister Gajendra Singh Shekhawat has questioned the authenticity of tapes that have been released by Congress. Shekhawat has, in fact, told CNN News 18, and I quote, "Who gave orders for phone tapping? Did Gehlot government record the audio?" Well, that's the question that Gajendra Shekhawat is in fact asking, that this is a case of phone tapping and whose permission was sought before phone tapping. Maria has more.